Hello everyone, this is Arshad Kumar and today I'm going to explain industry network security implementation and my project guide is Professor Didi Jala. This is the first one, my content in which I have included different kind of things. First is project definition, requirement of project, introduction of project, firewall, ASA features, port security, VPN, WPA, requirement for implementation of project, learnings for me, and references. Project definition. In its simplest term, it is a set of rules and configuration designed to protect the integrity, confidentiality, and accessibility of computer networks and data using both software and technologies. Now, requirement of project. We need a simple PC or laptop with the installed Cisco packet tracer for the implementation of topology. Operates in applications such as HTTP, FTP, SMTP means hypertext transfer protocol, light transfer protocol, simple middle transfer protocol. SAP, UDP, and network IP layer. Introduction of project. Network security is a broad term that covers a multitude of technologies, devices, and processes. Network security typically consists of three different controls: physical, technical, and administrative. Physical security controls are designed to prevent unauthorized personnel from gaining physical access to network components such as router. Technical security control protects the data that is stored on the network or which is transmitted across into or out of the network. Administrative security control consists of security policies and processes that control user behavior. First is firewall. In computing, a firewall is a network security system that monitors and controls incoming and outgoing traffic based on predetermined security rules. Firewall typically establishes a barrier between the untrusted external networks and your trusted internal network. Administrator typically configures a set of different rules that blocks or permit traffic onto the network. ASA filters. Packet filtering is a simple process of filtering the incoming or outgoing packet. By default, ASA performs stateful tracking of the packet if the packet is generated from higher security level to lower security level. Load balancing. Multiple clients can be set across multiple ASA units at the same time. AMP. Cisco ASA provides support for next generation firewall features, which can provide protection, advanced malware protection in a single device. This is my topology, which I have implemented for the ASA firewall. We'll see the details in the practical portion. Here you can see the output of my topology in right side bottom corner. It shows the successful transmission of packet from PC0 to server 0 and PC4 to server 0. Here PC0 and PC4 are various users. Port security helps secure the network by preventing unknown devices from forwarding packets. When a link goes down, all dynamically locked packets are read. Port security allows you to restrict a port ingress traffic by limiting the MAC address that are allowed to send traffic into the port. It has three tags: protect, restrict, and shutdown. Protect mode drops the packet with unknown switches, MAC address until you remove enough secure MAC addresses. Restrict is not performed the same function as protect. It drops the packets until enough secure MAC address and it is a long message. Shutdown. This mode is mostly referred as a compared to other mode as it shut down the port immediately if unauthorized access is done. This is the topology for pod security. Here there are three users, PC5, PC6, and PC7. PC5 and 6 can communicate with each other very easily because we have defined the port number with PC5 and 6. But PC7 can't communicate with PC6 because we didn't define any kind of port for PC7. Here you can see the successful transmission of packet from PC5 to PC6 and PC6 to PC5. This is the configuration. Again, you can create a connection to the network from another endpoint site. For example, if you are working from home, you would directly connect to the organization's network. Or a VPN, data between the two ports is encrypted and the user would need to authenticate to allow communication between the devices network. This is the topology for VPN. Here you can see the cluster 0 is visible, in which there are two routers, router 12 and router 14. It mounts the IP to router 13. If the user want to communicate from PC12 to PC13, but the site is denying, then they can use the VPN. PC12 send the packet to PC13 with the help of virtual private network. Here you can see the successful transmission of packet from PC12 to PC5 protected access. WPA encryption methods adopted in WPA is a protocol key integrity protocol. PKIP includes per packet key integrity leaking mechanism. It dynamically generates an encryption for each packet. It encrypts each data packet with a unique encryption key, and the key keys are much stronger than those of its predecessor. This is the topology for Wi-Fi protected access. Here you can see the door is closed in first image, and here the door is open in second image, which I have on my laptop or my mobile phone. We will see in the picture. Here you can see the topology for the various network security terms which I have implemented in Cisco Packet Tracer. You can see the four type of various four clusters. We will see them in there. First is ASA firewall. Here you can see the cluster 0 in which there are four different kinds of users from PC0 to PC4. If I want to send the packet from PC0 to my server using ASA firewall, I will select the PC0 and I want to transmit the packet to server 0. So it's showing the failed because configuration may take some time to configure all the ports and data. We'll try it again. PC0 to server. Again, it is showing fail. We'll try it again. PC0 to server 0. Now it is showing successful. Same way, I can select the different user PC4 and again transmit the data from PC4 to server 0. It is showing successful. Here, if any suspicious website or any kind of web browser are detected, ASA blocks the website or web page. It won't be visible to us. And if it is something found, here you can see the failed after the successful. Now we can see virtual private network. Here cluster 0. There are two routers in cluster 0, router fail and porting. But how it works? If I want to send from packet from PC 12 to PC 13, again strike fail because it may take some time to configure all the ports and data. We try again. Again, it's fine. Okay. Can see I'm sending the packet from PC 12 to PC 30. It is showing successful. Now it works. You see, if I send the packet from PC 12, it sends the router to router 12. Router 12 will send the here router 13, and router 13 will bounce the IP and encrypt the data, and it shows to router 14, and then router 14 will transmit the data to PC 13. You can see the successful transmission. Same way we can transfer the data from PC 13 to PC 12. Here you can see the successful. Now Wi-Fi protected access. First we need to log in with our laptop or phone. For that we need a IP address of the particular server. Okay, we are gaining this IP from server 2. This is the IP 192.168.0.10. Now I am logging with my laptop for operate my fan, door, lamp and gate. I'm going to desktop and web browser, and then signing with my IP. It shows me the login page. For in login page, I need to give username and password, and then sign in. It shows me for availabilities for fan, door, lamp, and gate. Here you can see I click on the gate. It is now closed. If I push the button, it's open. And here the fan, it is now working in full speed. If I want to load it, I press the lock. It is working in low mode. Now I want to off it, stop. So that's how the WPA works. Now port security. Again, PC5 and PC6 can communicate successfully because we have defined the port in configuration. Now, if I remove that cable and PC7 to PC6, it won't able to show successful communication. You can see the failed PC7 to PC6 because we don't define any port for PC7. Now again, we remove that cable and again turn for PC5. Oops, wait. Now again, we'll transmit to PC5 to PC6. It may take some time for building port and over the data. Once it is configured and set up all the data, it will allow us to transmit the data packet successfully. We try again. Still, we are not able to send it. Now again, we transmitted the data successfully from PC4 to PC6 because we have defined it in port to PC5 and PC6. So this is the topology. which I have implemented for the various kind of network security terms. Now, requirement of for implementation of project, we need a PC or laptop with latest version of Cisco Packet Tracer. Learning for me, understanding of various network security terms in detail. How ASF firewall works and how VPN works. Connect of VPN. How we can connect to the ASF firewall safely. How we can generate the virtual private network via our own. Systems of port security in networking. How port security works. These are the references which I have gained the knowledge to make the project running successfully. Thank you.